Today we're going to be back in chapter 16, page 614, 615, and 616. And remember, we're working out of the newest Milady book. We'll start at the top with level system. So your level system is the measure of lightness or darkness in a hair color. This can be artificial hair color, natural hair color, just hair color in general. Most lines are going to be 1 through 10. 1 is black, 10 is brightest blonde. Some hair color lines are going to be 1 through 12. So when you're looking at someone's hair, you'll say, oh, that's a level 5. That means on a scale of lightness to darkness, it's about a level 5. It can also be a 5.5, 4.5, 6.5. They can be halves as well. On the chart, it's 16-2 to the right. It's going to show you the level and the underlying pigment. And you can see it's going through shades of warm tones, yellows to orange to red. Underlying pigment is just the natural warmth that shows up when you lighten hair. So when you bleach hair, oftentimes it's going to turn orange or yellow. And bleach, lighten, when you lighten hair, so you're either going to get an orange tone or a yellow tone. So that's going to be really important when we go into correcting hair color or toning. If we lighten the hair up to a level 5, and you can look at your chart, you can see that it's probably going to have an orange to red tone to it. So if it's orange, to correct that, I'm going to need something blue, which is ash. On the focus on part, it's in blue. It's going over how lighting is critical when you're looking or analyzing hair color. In some lights, hair color is going to look red. In some, it's going to have a green cast. So the best way to determine hair color is to take your client outside with a handheld mirror and look at the hair in natural light if possible. So this little portion is just explaining that different lights cast different colors onto the hair. Hair color charts. These are also called shade charts or swatch charts. And this is a swatch book. This is a palmist one, so it goes through all the colors that they currently have. And actually, that's a lie because this is an older book. An example of a basic one is on the next page, 615, figure 16.3. It has listed the level 1 through 12, and then it's going to give you a primary and secondary tone. So what this means, if we have a 5A hair color, 5 is the level. Right here, this is saying this is a level 5 hair color. A for ash. What gets a little confusing about this is all hair color charts are different. This Paul Mitchell book isn't going to match a Wella book. The chart in your book isn't going to match this Paul Mitchell book. We're going to follow this basic one for this book, but once you get into a salon, you'll usually carry one color line and you'll memorize what those letters mean, letters or numbers. So let's do 6RV. This is what it will look like in Paul Mitchell the color. The 6 is representing the level. Remember, it can be 1 through 10 or 1 through 12. So it's saying this is a level 6 hair color, how light or dark it is. And that can be a little confusing because you're looking at it in lightness and darkness, not tone. Is it red? Is it orange? Is it green? Is it blue? When you're finding someone's level, you're thinking about their hair in black and white. If I turn this in black and white, how light or dark is it? That way you take out the tones, because sometimes the tones can trick you, make you think it's lighter or darker, but we're just looking at how light or how dark it is. So this is saying this number is the level, level 6. The first letter, and sometimes it's going to be a number, but for this we're using letters, this represents the dominant tone. So this is saying level 6, the R stands for red. So it's a level 6 with a dominant tone of red.
I don't have a violet marker, but V is violet.
And violet is its secondary tone. Red is listed first, dominant, so it's got more red than violet. And when you look at the swatch, you can see that it's more red than it is violet, but it has a cast of purple or violet. Some hair color lines are going to have what's called a break.
And a break can be a dot or a slash. So it would say 6.RV, 6/RV. All the break is doing is separating the level from the tone. 6.22. This is the level. This is the tone.
And then this is on the how to read a color chart.
Some hair color lines will do 5, let's do BV. It will be all capitalized. Some will read it like this, 5BV. This is just saying this is the dominant tone.
On the top of 615, it gives you a color key chart. This is your basic one. A for ash, which is gray. B for blue. G for gold. N for neutral, natural. NA, neutral ash. NB, neutral brown. NN, neutral or natural, double pigmented, that's for gray or to mix in with gray. O for orange, R for red, RO, red orange, RR, red red, RV, red violet, and V, violet. So as a loose guide, usually R is red, G is gold, V is violet. So it's just taking the first letter of the word to represent the tone.
So this color is level 5, blue, violet.
So that's a very loose guide on how to read a color chart. I know it's very confusing. Hopefully I simplified it enough, but if you have a certain brand that you're confused on, let me know and I can try to break that down for you. 616, which is the next page, you have a little lightning bolt up here. Activity. It's saying to take a half an inch square at the crown of the head, which is the top. You wear the crown on the top of your head. You could do it here or there, wherever. And you're gonna hold it up from the scalp so you can get light to pass through this. And using the end series of the color chart or the level finder, should look like this. You wanna go through and find what level this is. Fan it out and try to match. Remember, lightness or darkness, no tone. This is orange, but how light or dark is it? Then you could do it on the back of the head, the ends of someone's hair, just go around and try to do as many people as you can. You wanna get really good at knowing the level just by looking. Once you practice finding the level, then you can find the tone. This is how you're gonna create a formulation. So for example, this is an easier one. This hair is a level 10, it's the brightest blonde.
So on my paper, I would write, can you see that? Yes, I would write level 10.
And then beside it, I'm gonna write the tone. This is yellow.
Level 10, yellow.
But if she wanted to get at that icy platinum blonde,
the toner you would use, you could use a 10, 11, 12. Across from yellow is violet. So that's how you would correct that.
And at the beginning, when you're finding level, you just wanna write it on a piece of paper. You can even take a picture of the hair, flip it into black and white, and then look at it and see what is the level so your eyes aren't tricking you with the tone. And to clarify for the tone, they're probably referring more towards you saying it's warm or cool, at least in this chapter.
I went a little ahead with that. So 10, warm, yellow.
Warm colors are your reds, yellows, oranges, warm, fireplace. Cools are your mountainscapes, greens, blues, grays.
So if it's yellow, it's obviously warm.
Lastly, we're on gray hair at the bottom. Gray hair is gonna happen when hair starts to lose its pigment. You're getting this salt and pepper effect. Hair is slowly over time losing pigment. White hair is when it's lost all the pigment. And gray hair is progressive. It doesn't happen overnight. You don't wake up all of a sudden and have gray hair. It's a slow transition, and some faster than others due to genetics, aging, medication. A lot of things can factor in when you're considering gray hair. So also when you're listing your level and your tone with your partners, your buddies, it's a level 5, it's warm, it's cool, it's yellow. You could list the percentage of gray. Is it 25, 50, 75, or 100%? Because for hair color, it's very important to note if there's gray hair because the formula changes completely.
So when you're formulating, she has a level 5, it's warm, she has 25% gray. That means for us, if she doesn't like the warm, but wants to keep her level 5, we just bring that down. We add something with green to cancel that out. She has 25% gray. We're gonna add in the N series, or you could even use the NN series because she has gray again, 20 volume.
And that's a lot, but we're gonna break it down when we start moving forward. Next time we'll be on 617. That's gonna go through color theory, which is my favorite. And then we'll just continue on with this chapter.